Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand.
Godric's heart.
He would have killed me once he found the repository, if not before. I had no choice.
You're right. You had no choice. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting. You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
Astonishing.
That must be the way to the repository. I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
Search the area! Must be here somewhere!
We must be getting closer!
Crimson! You've been cleaned! You're now
broken in there!
You can't stop us. That was meant for me.
I shall handle it. One moment. Let's go.
Now there's nothing but luck!
Way forward.
Very perceptive, my young friend. It worked. Let's go.
Ragnarok must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do.
What?
Potato!
It's the students,
Billy!
And the Professor! Fools of a feather!
Closer, Professor. That way. Rebellion.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Steer them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Oh. They got this.
Look out! Another troll!
rest of us.
We couldn't be happy. You, Professor Sharp.
I'm relieved we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lot...
Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used.
She did not see what the keepers... You are now the keeper of whatever power... What do you intend to do with it?
I have decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen? What about...
No. You're right. I haven't forgotten. The cost is...
I'm relieved to hear that. I know the power. And whilst that may be the right decision in...
What is it, Professor?
I spent all year trying to keep our journey a secret from everyone. But now, the Keepers want to...
The Keepers will...
I understand.
But... The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository.
It's feeding off the power from the repository.
Your beautiful magic is no match for mine, child!
trick, is it? I have you now, Ragnarok.
Proceed!
Expelliarmus!
Yeah.
charade. You can't run forever, Ranrok. Dead Lord, now hide now, Ranrok.
Might ensure that your death is swift.
Good for you. Repent. Now, are you Ranrok? Thank you. happened?
Confringo! Professor Fig. Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
I'm truly awed by what we've accomplished.
Can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did, but it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrock, Isadora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrock. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy, but it was never that simple. I have a lot to think about. Let's speak again soon.
I used to write to my parents.
Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even helped Mr. Ollivander track down a family wand.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Miss Oni. I think her mother shares the sentiment. While I do not condone taking matters into your own hands when it comes to men like Rookwood and Harlow, your bravery is to be commended.
Thank you, Professor.
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. I see some progress here, but quite a bit of your field guide has yet to be completed. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor, for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us. By all accounts, Hogwarts would be lost without you.
how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder. Stop going.
Probably about time, though, isn't it?
What were you saying?
Oh.
About time for what?
She's referring to your statement. My statement.
It's a little out of date.
I beg your pardon, but would you mind helping out an old woman?
Alohomora. Mine now, Demi guys.
It's you! Thank you again for saving me. I'll never forget you.
There you are! You saved my little Archie from those awful monsters!
I wonder who lives here.
Oh, Milo, what am I to do?
Oh, Arnshire. This hamlet is simply crawling.
Alohomora.
Always a lovely place to visit. Give my best to you, my young friend.
Aloha, Mora.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Ugh.
enjoy your time in Irondale. Shame about Porrick's sister.
It must lead to something grand.
A veritable gem in the Highlands, Maranweem. Welcome.
Aloha, Mora.
You can't keep your eyes off of me.
back here. Hello, Mr. Moon.
Oh, great.
I actually...
Dear me, you're ready for the final Alaha. You have done all I... If you do find more, and if I ever find... Thank you. Now that you've mastered Alaha Mora, no lock is unbreakable.